Your phone knows where it is, like all the time, even when you're not asking, even when you're in the middle of a forest, holding it up like Simba, praying for a single bar of signal, it still knows. And that's terrifying, but also kind of amazing. Imagine handing a modern smartphone to a medieval monk. He'd probably think it was a demon trapped in glass. Then you open Google Maps and it shows you exactly where you are. Boom, heresy, straight to the dungeon. So how does this work? How does a slab of metal and glass know it's chilling outside a Taco Bell at 2 a.m.? Let's break it down. First off, there's GPS, global positioning system. Sounds fancy? It's basically a bunch of space robots. Okay, satellites, just floating around up there, constantly yelling their location. Your phone listens to at least four of them at once. Not one, not two, four, because triangulation is for amateurs. We're doing quadrangulation, baby. Each satellite sends a timestamp signal. Your phone catches it and says, cool, you're 20,000 kilometers away. Then it does that with three more satellites. Using the time it took for each signal to arrive, it calculates how far it is from each one. Then it draws invisible spheres around each satellite. Where those spheres intersect, that's you, standing in line for a Crunchwrap Supreme. But wait, satellites are in space. Space is far, like really far. How does your phone hear them? Well, GPS signals are weak, like whispering through a wall weak. But your phone's antenna is tuned to listen for those whispers. It's like a nosy neighbor with super hearing, and it's constantly eavesdropping on space. Now, GPS is great, but it's not perfect. Go inside a building and suddenly your phone's like, you're somewhere near Earth? So it cheats, it uses Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi routers have names, like Netgear 420 or Mom's Internet Don't Touch. Your phone sees those names and checks a massive database. Oh, Netgear 420 lives at 123 Main Street. Boom, location confirmed. Still not enough? Let's throw in cell towers. Your phone is always talking to them, even when you're not on a call. It's like a clingy friend who texts, hey, every 5 minutes. Each tower knows roughly how far you are based on signal strength. Combine three towers and you get another triangulation or trigonometric wizardry, whatever. But wait, there's more. Bluetooth beacons. These tiny devices sit in malls, airports, and stores. They scream, I'm here, I'm here. Your phone hears them and says, cool, I must be near the Cinnabon. It's like breadcrumb trails for your digital self. And then there's motion sensors, accelerometers, gyroscopes, magnetometers. Your phone is basically a tiny NASA lab. It knows when you're walking, running, falling, or doing the worm. Combine that with location data and it can guess your path. Oh, you walked 20 meters north, turned left, and fell into a bush. Thanks, phone. But how does it all stay accurate? Magic. Okay, not magic. Math. Your phone constantly cross-references all these sources. GPS says you're here, Wi-Fi says you're slightly over there, cell towers say you're somewhere in between, your phone averages it out and says, you're probably here-ish, and it's usually right. Now, privacy. Yes, your phone knows where you are. Yes, apps can ask for that info, but you can say no. Or, only while using the app. Or, never, you creepy little rectangle. Still, it's wild. We took sand, melted it into glass, shoved some metal in there, and now it knows where it is on a planet spinning through space. Also, you can find the nearest bubble tea shop. So next time your phone says you're here, just nod and whisper, thanks little space wizard, and maybe give it a pat. It's earned it. Smash that like button like it owes you money. Subscribe so you never miss another weekly dose of everyday sorcery. Your phone's a space wizard. Act accordingly.